Hi, my name is Noah Gift, and today I'm going to talk about the AWS .NET deployment tool for the .NET CLI. What I'm going to do is open up Cloud 9, a cloud-based development environment. I'm going to create a new .NET 6 Blazor application. I'm going to take that application, run it locally, show how you can preview it, change the actual web pages as well locally, then deploy it with just one command to AWS ECS and Fargate and create a really a production quality deploy with just a few terminal commands here inside of AWS Cloud 9. All right, let's go ahead and get started. All right, let's take a look at what we're actually going to deploy and how we're going to do it. First, I'm going to spin up an AWS Cloud 9 environment. I like Cloud 9 for developing with AWS because I can pick any size instance I want. I can pick a 32-core machine if I want with lots of RAM. And then I'm also going to install the .NET 6 framework, then get a Blazor application running, test it out with preview. When I'm ready to go, I'm going to put a Dockerfile together and then run .NET AWS deploy. What this will do is hook up a cloud formation process as well as an ECR image that will get pushed into ECS, a IAM role, a VPC, all will be set up, and my Blazor application will be running as a task inside of ECS, all with this one command. Okay, let's go ahead and do it. All right, so I'm inside of AWS Cloud 9 here. I picked a large machine that I'm going to use to do my development task. To spin up a Cloud 9 environment, you can go to AWS and just select Cloud 9 and configure your own environment with the defaults. I would probably pick as the only option in the default I would change is a bigger machine. In this case, this is, I think, at least an 8-core machine with lots of RAM. Now, the first thing that you want to do for .NET 6 is to make sure that you have the latest packages. You can see I'm going to go ahead and do that, sudo rpm. I'm going to add the Microsoft CentOS packages. Next up, I would want to make sure that I'm installing .NET 6. Here we go, sudo yum install. And this will make sure that .NET 6 is installed. And then I'll want to install as well the ASP.NET Core runtime. And then the final thing I'll install is the .NET runtime for 6. There we go. Once I've got this, all I need to do to run the AWS deployment tools is to run this command, which is .NET tool update -g aws.deploy.tools. Once I do this, it'll go through here and check to make sure that I've got the latest version. Because this tool is installed very frequently, you can see I've already been able to install it with the latest tool. It's a good idea to just run this fairly frequently. So the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to create a Blazor application. In this case, it'll be .NET space new space Blazor server dash O Blazor app. And I'm going to say dash F net 6.0. So I'm going to make a .NET 6 Blazor app. Okay. You can see it's very fast. And then I'm going to CD into this Blazor app directory. Now, once I've done this, all I need to do in order to run it is to run a .NET command that gives it the ability to run on port 8080. And the reason for this is that this will allow the preview functionality to work. So in this case, I say .NET run dash dash URLs equals, and then I put in the localhost 8080 path, and this will go ahead and run my Blazor application. You'll see it'll run in foreground mode. Now, in order to test it out, pretty straightforward, I would just go to this preview icon, click it, and then select preview running application. And there we go. We see that this thing is actually running. I can even make it a little bit bigger. And I can actually go to this menu bar here, look at the counter, go ahead and click it. And you can see I'm actually running this application, which is nice. Now, all I need to do to deploy this is to make whatever changes I want to make and then go ahead and deploy. So I think what I'll probably do here is just tweak this application just a little bit by going inside of the Blazor app, going down to wherever the index lives here, which should be inside of pages and index razor. Okay. Now I'll go ahead and paste up some new code here. In this case, I'll just say the root page. I want it to say index still. I want to say hello, AWS.net, AWS deploy. Welcome to your new app. I could test it if I want, just to be extra safe. Let's go ahead and go and preview it. And we can see here that it should be running. There we go. We can see hello, AWS.net, AWS deploy. Perfect. All right, so now that I've got this thing running, it's time to do a deploy. Fortunately, it's pretty straightforward. And I'm going to first make a Docker file. So go ahead and say touch Docker file. And inside of this Docker file, I'm going to configure how I want it to deploy as a container. So I'll go here and paste this in. Let's go ahead and take a look real quick. So I just use a Microsoft.NET 6 as a base image here. I then go through and I build the project out and I expose port 80 and port 443. And then finally, I publish this application by exposing the .dll. Right, so it has to be blazerapp.dll, perfect. Now that that's running, pretty straightforward. I could even test out the local build process as well, which is not a horrible idea. So if I want to test out what this Docker container would look like, it would be pretty easy to do. All I would need to do is run a Docker build command. Okay, now in order to run it, I would just run docker run -p 8080, which would be the port that is going to preview locally, and then 80, which is what's internal here to this Docker file. If I go ahead and I run this, you can see that it's able to listen on port 80 internally to this Docker container. And then if I select preview, it'll expose port 8080, which allows us to preview this application. So it looks like it's ready to go here, which is great. Now, the only thing I need to do is to go down and run this AWS deployment command here, which is pretty straightforward to do. I'll just need to write .net AWS deploy. And because I have a Docker container, it is pretty smart. What it'll do is it'll give me a default here that will say what it is I want to do. I can make this window a lot bigger and says, look, it says ASP.NET core application to Amazon ECS using Fargate. This application will be deployed to Amazon Elastic Container Service. If your project doesn't contain a Dockerfile, it will be automatically generated. So this is exactly what I want. So I'm gonna go ahead and just pick one, which is already the default. And then it's gonna ask me what to name it. I'm gonna go ahead and leave the default here, which is the Blazor app. And then finally, it'll show me the cluster settings for ECS. So the name of the cluster, the service name, how many tasks it wants. So it'll be load balanced to have three different tasks running. It'll set up the role, it'll set up the VPC, and even environmental variables that I would pass, and even would go to ECR and hook into that repository. So I'm gonna go ahead and say enter. Now what it's gonna do is gonna build this container, and it's going to push this container to ECR and then set up the cloud-based deploy using CloudFormation and AWS CDK. And the CDK is a library that works with multiple languages that generates CloudFormation code. So this is going to handle all of these very complex steps for me automatically. And here we can see that the process is happening here, and it's going to go ahead and deploy our application. All right, so we're ready to go here. You can see that the deployment took 255 seconds. And if I go over to this endpoint right here, I can actually copy it and actually paste this into a browser window. And you see I've got the AWS.NET deploy working. Now, the other thing to point out is if I go over to ECS here and I go to the clusters, I can also see all of the handiwork that's been set up here. Look, we've got Blazor running. In fact, I have three running tasks. I have an active service that's actually been able to be executed. So in a nutshell, our .NET AWS deploy tool is really a miracle worker, and it creates a very high quality production deploy.